Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about another three functions under parent-child DAX functions. That is PATHITEM, PATHITEMREVERSE, PATHLENGTH. We are seeing about parent-child relationship where you have an employee table as an example. Employee ID, name and designation. These three columns belongs to an employee. And we have a manager ID, which is nothing but this is the foreign key reference to the same table, that is employee ID. So this is what a typical parent-child relationship is. And for that, you need to iterate or find out which hierarchy this employee falls or who is reporting to what, right? So we have created this path using a path function. So if you haven't watched it, you can go and watch my previous video, which says about how to create a hierarchy or path using a parent-child functions. Now, in this video, we will try to understand what is PATHITEM, PATHITEMREVERSE, PATHLENGTH functions, and when to use it. That's what we are going to see as part of this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. As you can see here, the same table, and we have created this path or hierarchy, hierarchical path. Basically, this is hierarchical path using simple path function. This path function takes input as employee ID and manager ID. This is this column, these two columns, and it creates the path. As you can see from this example, consider this particular row. There is 112. Who is he reports, his manager is 106, that is what here, and the 106 in turn reports to 102, 102 reports to 101. Let's try to find out. 106 reports to 102, is that correct? 106 reports to 102, 102 reports to 101, 101 is the CEO. So this is what this function will return the path. Now, we will try to create a path item function. What it does, let us name it as same with the function name so that we will try to compare. So path item, it takes the path. As I mentioned before, we can either start creating the path again, like path of employee ID comma manager ID comma, okay, then close bracket to, it is done already. Now we go for position. This path item basically trying to get the employee ID reference, who is from the, if you want, who is at from the top, who is at the second position for each employee, right? Let's say you put 2 and then you put 0. 0 is nothing but for if it has to be the return item should be of text or integer. Okay, let us go for 0, that is default. It will return as text. Then once you press enter, what it does basically, consider this example 111. For 111, 101 is at the top level and 102 is at the second level. So we are asking for this employee, give me this, who is at from the second position from the top, okay, and return the value in the text. So this is what this is written. Now for the same employee, I want who is at the third position. Just go and change it to 3 here from the top. You can see 101, 102, 105. 105 is written. Where in case, if you see here, 101, 104, 114. For 114, only 3 levels, okay? So, who is at the third level? He is at the third level. So, this employee, the same employee is written. What happens to this employee when you put 4? It will return blank because there is no one at the fourth level for this employee because only 3 levels exist in his path. Now, so this is what your path item function is. Basically, it will return the item or the employee or the member from the specified position from the top. What in case if you require from the bottom, right? So basically this particular 112 is the bottom level and he is the next level and he is the next level. Higher level goes like this. This is right to left is from bottom to top. From left to right is the top to bottom. So in this case, the path item functions from the top to bottom. What happens if you want a member from the bottom to top? So another function that does the same job from the bottom to top is nothing but path item reverse. Path item reverse. Okay. The syntax remains same. Path item reverse. Now, as I mentioned, you can use the path of again the same function, or if you have this column derived, that hierarchical column, see, I can use this column as well, okay, because the hierarchy column is nothing but path of employee ID comma manager ID. So I'm using the derived column as well. Now in this case, as I specified, we will put path item reverse. Here you can see the path item takes the from the top to bottom, the second position. Path item reverse from bottom to top. So 106 is written in case of path item reverse, 102 is written in case of path item. So this is the difference between path item and path item reverse. And also, as I mentioned, the last parameter which is nothing but either return text or integer. 0 is for text, 1 is for integer. When you specify 1, it will return as a integer. If you see, it moved towards the right, which is nothing but a data type as integer. It's your choice how you evaluate in your business, whether you want to go for it text or integer. Then we are going to see about the last function today, which is nothing but path length. Path underscore length equals path of length comma, again it can be any column. I already derived, so I will use the hierarchical column. That's it. So basically it gives for each employee what is the total length in which from the top he is under which level. Basically he is at the fourth level, he is at the third level, and he is at the second level. So this is what the path length function will do. So if you are asking me when you need to use all these parent-child functions is called, you have to evaluate, right, based on different levels. From the top position, like consider these are the DCOs. For each DCOs, it will be always at the second level, right? So here you can get the second level. It will always return the who is at the DCOs. So you can aggregate your data based on your DCOs. What I'm trying to say is, for each employee you have some expenses, but you want to aggregate at the DCO level, then you can put this path item of the path and second level. So DCO level you can aggregate for each employees, right? So like this, there are a lot of business scenarios where you have to aggregate or do your calculation at the part of the hierarchy or in different levels. So in those cases, these path related functions will be really useful and you can utilize for your business scenarios. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.